station looks and feels apocalyptic.
Looks like a bomb went off. Nothing left of, you know, these homes.
This is the stuff you have nightmares about.
This is absolutely devastating. It's heartbreaking. It is crushing. This looks like another planet.
It's probably reminiscent of hell. There's still some fires because the gas is still...
Looks like hell on Earth, and I would have to say that's a very accurate description of what we're looking down on.
It's a guided tour through hell as flames consume an entire Santa Rosa neighborhood.
What the hell is going on? You good, son?
What do you think about this? It's covering us now. Look at the sun. It's red. It's a solar eclipse.
Wine country fires claiming at least 26 lives by Thursday, making it the state's deadliest wildfire event in over 8 decades, and things could get worse with hundreds still missing. Nearly 24 blazes have scorched over 190,000 acres, an area nearly the size of New York City, destroying at least 3,500 homes and buildings in its path. Fire officials have said some of the victims were asleep when the fast-moving fires engulfed their homes before they could escape, and some bodies they found were no more than ash and bone.
We have cadaver dogs up here that basically can scent bodies and help us find people.
But for the first time since the fire started on Sunday, officials saying they are starting to gain ground over the flames. Reuters' Noel Randowich is in Calistoga, Napa Valley, which was evacuated late Wednesday.
Inside of Calistoga, it's pretty much abandoned except for police at checkpoints. Behind me, you can see a house. There's nobody home, but the owner, he's left a sprinkler on over his roof, clearly in an attempt to minimize the possibility of his house catching on fire.
In Sonoma County alone, there were still 463 people listed as unaccounted for, but it's still unclear how many of them might be victims rather than evacuees who failed to alert authorities after fleeing their homes. About 25,000 people remain displaced, and the smoke from Napa and Sonoma have drifted over the San Francisco Bay Area an hour drive south, leaving it in a haze and automobiles coated with ash.
No end in sight as of Friday for the roughly two dozen wildfires burning in Northern California that have now claimed the lives of at least 31 people and have left hundreds missing in the heart of wine country. It's the most lethal wildfire event in California's history, killing people while they slept in their beds. California's Director of Emergency Services saying the loss of cell towers in the fires likely contributing to difficulties in warning residents. Firefighters facing yet another round of dry, windy conditions Friday. The National Weather Service saying 60-mile-an-hour winds and low humidity will, quote, contribute to extreme fire behavior into Saturday. Thousands of homes and businesses have been incinerated, with entire neighborhoods in the city of Santa Rosa turned to smoldering ruins. The Napa Valley town of Calistoga could meet the same fate as the fire creeps closer. Mayor Chris Canning saying anyone refusing to heed the mandatory evacuation would be left to fend for themselves.
They're 85 years old and I just don't know if they can rebuild. I mean, so many family heirlooms. I've thought my whole life I'm going to inherit these someday. This is what I'm going to pass down to my kids. Oh God, I can't.
All your life savings and work for all the years is gone. Since we've lived here 10 years, I never thought that Santa Rosa would have a fire like this, and we would lose everything.
You know how many of you came to my house and shared our beautiful view and our beautiful sky? But this is it.
We're trying to find which house was ours.
Went to bed about 12, and my one dog, she's really alert to things. She started barking and just wanting me to check on stuff. It was really windy. I went out front, wind's blowing, ashes coming down. Just grabbed my keys, my truck, and my dogs, and took off. I'm just glad to be here, glad to have my dogs. You know, you can replace the stuff, but life's most important.
California is worsening, and there appears to be no end in sight. The fires are now blamed for at least 23 deaths. 285 other people are reported missing, though officials suspect many of them are just out of touch with loved ones. 3,500 homes and businesses have been destroyed.
And think about this. There are entire towns that are under evacuation orders. Highway patrol officers went door to door in parts of Sonoma County overnight, strongly advising homeowners to leave, get out.
At least 22 large fires are burning in California at this hour. Carter Evans is in Santa Rosa, where firefighters are still having trouble getting into some burned out areas. Carter, good morning.
Good morning. I'm standing in front of what was once a Kmart that has been obliterated. You can just imagine how hot it was to bend those steel I-beams and take a look inside. You can see the burned out shopping carts there. This is what it looked like when it was fully engulfed. Firefighters say there was nothing they could do. Towering flames lit up the night sky, a warning to those still in the path of the wildfire. In parts of California, the safest place to view it is from the air. California Highway Patrol captured hillsides and towns burning to the ground.
There's been fires that just blow through. This has been going on for 3 days with no resolution. We're just on edge right now.
The fires have now burned about 265 square miles, an area half the size of Los Angeles.
We are in this fight for the long haul. It's going to continue to get worse before it gets better.
More than 8,000 firefighters are facing extremely dry conditions. Gusty winds, some topping 75 miles per hour, are changing direction with each passing minute.
Any change in these winds and it's pushing the fire right through this dry grass towards homes.
Battalion Chief Jonathan Cox says some of these firefighters have been working nonstop since Sunday. They're fighting extreme exhaustion, with some men catching sleep whenever they can.
We have dozens of firefighters who've been affected themselves, lost homes, had families who've been impacted.
And they're still out here fighting the
fire?
And
they're still out here fighting the fire.
What's happening?
New video from when the wildfire broke out shows first responders driving right into the inferno. More than 20,000 people have been evacuated from their homes. One family put sprinklers on their roof and begged first responders to save their house. Meanwhile, some are returning to the most devastated areas for the first time to see the damage up close.
This is absolutely devastating. It's heartbreaking. It is crushing. This looks like another planet.
98% of all wildfires are caused by people, but it is still not clear what caused this one. There were reports of very windy weather downing trees, power poles, and power lines before the fire began on Sunday. Pacific Gas and Electric, the electric company out here, says it notified fire officials right away, and they are now investigating. Charlie?
Thanks, Carter.
It's a guided tour through hell as flames consume an entire Santa Rosa neighborhood.
This whole side of the block's gone.
Larry Broderick drives down his street to see his worst fears realized.
No fire trucks anywhere.
Nearly every home on Broderick's block is up in flames. Here's the moment he discovers his own house has been destroyed.
There's my neighbor's house right back up to my house, so my house is gone.
We spoke to the father of three today.
It's like a apocalyptic war zone. It's disheartening and it's challenging.
My house is gone.
Dramatic drone footage in daylight reveals the view from above. Complete devastation as far as the eye can see. Home after home, street after street in Santa Rosa reduced to rubble. Wildfires have burned nearly 180,000 acres throughout the state. That's half the size of Los Angeles.
I can't believe this happened. It was home. We raised our children here. They went to school, the local school. Just memories, friendships.
Everything was lost. Then, by some miracle, she finds her most treasured possession in a pile of ash. It's her wedding ring.
I went straight to where I knew my jewelry box was, and it was there.
A small glimmer of hope amid so much loss.
It means everything, because at least I have something. I mean, you can see that there's nothing really
here. In Northern California, the fires have destroyed more than 1,500 homes and businesses, including its famous wineries. The devastation looks and feels apocalyptic.
It looks like a bomb went off. Nothing left of, you know, these homes.
This is the stuff you have nightmares about, you know, your home burning down.
Firefighters are battling an unusually large number of blazes, 14 in Northern California, plus a quickly moving one in Southern California. But because of the intensity of the flames, the firefighters had to work primarily just to get people out.
Life is our primary focus here, and we need you to evacuate so that we can protect you.
The fires have forced tens of thousands of Californians to flee. In the Northern California city of Santa Rosa, hospital staff had to evacuate patients on gurneys. To the south in Anaheim, parents rushed to pick up their children from school while plumes of smoke hovered over nearby Angel Stadium and Disneyland. Many residents have struggled to quickly gather their belongings and flee their homes.
I'm in shock, Chris. This is your life.
October is known as the worst time of the year for California wildfires. But normally, the state is not battling so many at the same time. Wind and low humidity have not helped. Firefighters say there's no known connection between the fires, and they're not sure what started them. A Officials have received more than 100 reports of missing persons, and authorities warn the death toll could rise.
Now we moved, and you got to see this to believe this. I'm going to have Martin pan off to the left. You're looking at a neighborhood that goes block after block after block that is completely and totally and overwhelmingly destroyed. You rarely see anything like this. Now, you might see this out in the countryside somewhere, but in a urban area like this, to see this kind of fire, it really goes back to the days of the Oakland Hills fire. But this is in the flats here. The wind was blowing, and obviously this just became an incinerator. This is called Coffee Park. It's a part of Santa Rosa, not far from the freeway. And this place is just destroyed. There's really almost nothing left. We have some people walking up and down, some of them seeing their houses for the first time, breaking into tears, and just having a god-awful time. Now, if you come back around this way, Martin, what I want to do is kind of give people, again, the scape here. Look at the scope of this thing. This is so hard to believe because this was, 24 hours ago, this was a neighborhood. There are garbage cans out in the street waiting for pickup. There are cars that were here that people simply didn't have enough people to drive away. And you're looking at a scene that is probably reminiscent of hell. There's still some fires because the gas is still on. But again, the fire's not spreading anywhere. And when we take a look at this, it's amazing. Now, I'm going to ask Martin to take the camera off of the tripod, so it's going to jerk around a little bit here, but I want to show you something that's just amazing. We're going to walk down this hill now, and we're going to take a look at, the ironies around here are just hard to believe, but take a look over here on this corner. There's a house that has a for sale sign, and that house was a for sale. It's not even a house anymore, and we're seeing this literally every place you look. I see, actually, from where I'm standing, I see a row of houses over there, but for blocks and blocks, there is nothing but complete destruction here. And when you look at all of this destruction, you realize that these are people's homes. This is where they were living. This is what they abandoned yesterday because they had to, literally in the middle of the night, and they come back and see this. This is just one of the kind of worst scenes that you can possibly imagine. And this is what we're looking at. Coffee Park near Santa Rosa's downtown, not terribly far away. And just look, I mean, yes, the cross streets here are Santiago and Camino del Prado. Not terribly far from the first neighborhood that we were in, but that was one where you had a square block that was just taken out. This one is block after block after block. It's really almost hard to imagine what's going on here, and the loss of property here is easily in the hundreds of millions of dollars, easily. And the damage to the infrastructure and everything else, this is going to take a long, long time to fix. And I mean, you just look at it and you realize how bad can actually be. And people are walking around. Some people are looking around there. As I said, they came back to their houses, but people are walking around. Many of them just, I wouldn't say it's shock, but just like in shock disbelief that this much damage could happen this quickly in such an urban area as this. You know, Santa Rosa is no little town. It's a very sizable city, and here you have this kind of destruction going on. So what we will do is we will obviously keep looking for more of this. We may have to spend hours in this neighborhood alone because, I say, you're just the view from one corner. You can hardly see anything but just total destruction. So that is the situation. If you have any questions, I'll try to answer them.
Tom, what you're showing us kind of just tells me the story of what those residents faced last night. They really had no chance to get anything. I mean, it was live or die. Get in the car and go.
And I'm telling you something, that is exactly right, because when you take a look at some of these trees, like look at this one over here. This tree was a pine tree. Look at it. It's just hardly anything left, just at the very top, and that's all ashes. Look at all these trees. This was a firestorm of the first water. I mean, it's hard to believe just how much this fire happened. Now, look over here to the right at this very, very tall tree, and you can see that that was a pine tree, but it was taken out, and that's got to be a good 50, 60 feet above the ground at the very least. And all of these trees are destroyed, so they're not going to come back. They're going to have to come in here and do all the other things that they have to do, but this is pretty much total destruction. You can't destroy this much more than this is destroyed.
Okay, Tom Baker.